Hot pot is awesome. You should be eating more of it, and you should do it at home. See, what hot pot is a form of communal eating, sort of in the mold of something like Korean barbecue or perhaps a cookout. And it's one of the tastiest ways that you can feed a crowd with a minimum amount of hassle. Now, of course, when I say this word hot pot, for a lot of you, your mind might immediately jump to that cauldron of bubbling heat that is Sichuan-style hot pot. And while we do absolutely love that stuff too, hot pot is way more than just that. You can find hot pots everywhere from Japan in the form of shabu-shabu, to Thailand in the form of taisuki or steamboats. And yet, despite its ubiquity throughout Asia, hot pot is certainly not without its critics. Author Fuchsia Dunlop has called the continued popularity of hot pot restaurants a negative, and food critic Choi Lan in Hong Kong infamously labeled them a cooking method that totally lacks cultural significance. But if you listen to most criticisms in the West, they generally seem to revolve around,
what kind of restaurant makes you cook your own food?
And in some ways, I do get it. If you're new to a cuisine, a Sichuanese fly restaurant or a Japanese izakaya is going to offer a lot more in the way of new, interesting foods than a pot of bubbling broth is. But the way I'd think about hot pot is more like a cookout. If you're anything like me, some of the most fun I've ever had cooking and eating are with friends or family circled around a grill or campfire. Hot pot is in that tradition. But the big benefit for you, the cook, it takes, like, all the pressure off you. For example, if you were cooking a normal Chinese-style meal for, I don't know, your extended family, for 8 people or so, that'd be something like 7 dishes that you'd need to whip up. Sometimes you might be down for the project, but that can get pretty stressful to execute. Much less stressful is making or even buying a great hot pot base, slicing some stuff up, and gathering around a pot. It's a proper feast for a fraction of the effort. But where we do partially agree with some of the critics is that while it's definitely fun some of the time, you don't always have to pay restaurant premiums for someone else to slice your beef for you. So in a sec, I'll be handing it off to Steph, who will show you how to approach making a basic store-bought base hot pot at home, followed by how you can make your own soup base if you're feeling a bit more ambitious. And finally, a cool example from the Guizhou province of how you can turn that basic soup base into something a bit more interesting.
So let's assemble some hot pot. Easiest ways to do it, you can just go to Asian supermarket and pick up some hot pot base. You're gonna add water to this stuff and make your pot. There are a bunch of brands and flavors, so feel free to explore. Outside of China, the brand Haidi Lao is readily available and solid enough. Second thing you need is some kind of portable burner. We just used this one, the little butane camper burner we use in the videos, but electric ones is also a popular choice. For the pot itself, nothing fancy, just use whatever pot you have. A Dutch oven would totally just work fine. Next, choose the stuff you want to put into your hot pot. Referring to what hot pot restaurants serve, you give you a pretty good idea of what's common, so we'll have an example menu in the description box. So for example, thinly sliced beef or lamb rolls are pretty classic. They are frozen meat cut into 1 millimeter thin slices with a deli slicer. The easiest way to get that thinness is to just go get the pre-sliced ones. If you can't find that or you don't want to buy frozen hot pot meat, you can also thinly slice some fresh meat yourself. But don't stress, because not all meat needs to be paper thin. For us, our hot pot must-haves also include some tofu puffs or skins, frozen meatballs, root vegetables, and some greens. But again, remember to check out the description box for a more complete discussion. Then once all your stuff is ready, just mix the base according to the package, bring it to a boil, and move it over to your burner. Start your relaxing and enjoyable meal over the steamy pot, chill with your friends, watch a movie, cook your food bit by bit, slow down, and relax. Stuff like root vegetables can go in first because it takes a while to cook. The rest of your food can be readied in little by little. If you worry about raw meat cross-contamination, you can just use a separate pair of chopsticks just for that purpose. You will dip your food with dipping sauces as you eat. At hotpot restaurants, they have a whole section dedicated to dipping sauces. So there's no way we can be comprehensive here. For a spicy one, my favorite is adding minced garlic with toasted sesame oil. And for a non-spicy one, you can't go wrong with chili soy sauce, which is simply mixing fresh heaven-facing chili with light soy sauce. So right, now that we have some basic ideas on how to assemble a hot pot meal, let's move on to the next level, making your own base. First, let's make a non-spicy, Cantonese-style pork bone broth. Here we have 500 grams of pork bone. First, soak it in water for half an hour to draw out some myoglobin and give it a cleaner flavor. Next, put it in a pot, add cool water to it, bring it to a boil together, and simmer for a couple minutes, then take it out and give it a rinse. Next, long yao. Get your stock pot piping hot, shut off the heat, add in the oil, here about half tablespoon, and heat on medium, add in your bones. Fry it for about 2 to 3 minutes, or until it's lightly brown. Then add in 2.5 liters or 10 cups of hot boiled water. Hot water here helps the protein and fat emulsify, and it's a very important trick to get a nice milky stock. Now bring that to a boil, add in 2-inch ginger smashed, a couple 2-inch section datong, aka Welsh onion, for sweetness. If you can't find that, you can use 1/8 inch white onion to replace it. And plus now add in 1 tablespoon of liaozhou, aka Shaoxing wine. Cover, heat on medium-low, and let it simmer for at least 2 hours. Then, for some extra flavor, at the 1 hour mark, get about 500 grams of daikon peeled and cut into 2-inch chunks. Add it in and let it simmer together for another hour. After that time, season the broth with 1/2 tablespoon of salt and 1 teaspoon of chicken bouillon powder, plus optionally a sprinkle of white pepper, and now your pork bone hot pot base is ready to serve. Now, let's move on to our third one here, a very interesting one from the Guizhou province, Guiyang-style pickled greens and beans hot pot, 酸菜豆米火锅. So first, get 120 grams of lima beans, give it a rinse, and soak it overnight in the fridge. Next day, to a pot of 2 liters of boiling water, add in the beans. Bring it to a heavy simmer, cover, and let it cook for 2 hours or until it's soft enough to mash. Or you can alternatively use a pressure cooker to do this job if you have one. 2 hours later now, our beans are ready. Scoop out the beans, save half, and mash half with a cleaver. And don't toss the cooking liquid. We'll need to reserve 2 cups of this liquid for our base later. Now, let's fry the base. As always, first, long yao. First, get your wok piping hot, shut off the heat, add in oil, here about 1 tablespoon, and give it a swirl to get a nice non-stick surface. And now add in about 200 grams of pork belly. This is a pork belly that's sliced into about 1/2 centimeter thick pieces and marinated with 1 teaspoon of light soy sauce. Fry it for about 5 minutes or until the pork belly has rendered out some fat, and then take it out and set them aside. Next, add in 3 cloves of garlic and 2-inch ginger, both roughly smashed. Fry it till fragrant, and then add in 150 grams of minced Chinese pickled mustard greens, aka suancai, which you should be able to find at most Chinese supermarkets. Now fry this together until it's fragrant, about 1 minute, and add in the mashed beans. Fry it together for another minute, then take it out and set aside. Now get your serving pot, add in 2 cups of the bean cooking liquid and 4 cups of stock. You can use whatever stock that's available to you. They like to use pork bone stock in Guizhou. You can also use the stock that we showed earlier in the video, but remember to check out the notes on how to use that. While bringing it to a boil, add in the fried bean paste and remaining beans. After it's at a boil, add in some corn, put the fried pork bellies back in, add in 1 sliced tomato and 2 sprigs of green garlic cut into 1-inch sections. You can use scallion if you can't find that. And lastly, season with 1/2 tablespoon of salt and 1 teaspoon chicken bouillon powder. and that's it. Your pickled greens bean hot pot base is ready to go onto your dinner table. So right, we discussed three types of hot pot base today and the basic components of a hot pot meal. But hot pot being such a broad topic, we just can't cover it in one video. So remember to check out the description box and pin notes for more tips and discussion. And also let us know in the comment section what is your favorite hot pot and the dipping sauce to go with it. And finally, as always, thank you for everyone that's supporting us on Patreon. And don't forget to subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos.